Very much. We have a silent auction going on in the next room. Please feel free to frolic about and bid on any items. We have a 50-50 raffle going on. We have music going on till about 8:30. We got terrific musicians for you. We're going to be starting off with my friend James Prickett here. Yeah, let's hear it for James. No more fireball ever. Who was that? I'm out. Anyway, this is our good friend Brett Lee. He's going to be the host of the Hope is Best 2017. I'm going to turn it over to him, and then we're going to turn it over to James. So please stick around. Brett, take it away.
We'll just lower this for the short people in the group. Thank you all for coming out. Good afternoon. Welcome to the pond, and welcome to our two-month annual Hope is Best fundraiser for NAMI Delaware. For those of you who are unfamiliar with NAMI, it is the National Alliance on Mental Illness. That is a disease that touches just about everybody. If it has not touched you or your family, God bless, and let me rub you for luck. Because it is a disease that is within nearly all of us. It is sometimes brought upon by circumstance, it is sometimes brought upon by the world around us, and so it's very difficult to diagnose and very difficult to help out where we can. That's where organizations like NAMI come in. NAMI in Delaware provides helpline services and meetings for people who are in need. They help them find resources for education, for living conditions, for job training. They do a lot of wonderful work. Their reach is limited only by their resources, and that's why we do this every year. The more that we can, more money we can put in their hands, the more good work they can do. So, without further ado, then, I will. James, you ready for me?
Sure.
I'm going to get the hell out of your way then. Ladies and gentlemen, James Prickett for you.
That's good. I'm stuck in Folsom prison. And time keeps dragging on. That train keeps on moving on down the sand. When I was just a baby, Mama told me, son, always be a good boy. Don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head up. Well, there's probably rich folks in a fancy dining car, probably drinking coffee and a smoking big cigars. But I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. Those people that keep on moving, that's what tortures me. Prison is where I want to stay.